Hi boys and girls, Miss Donna's here. How you doing today? Today is Father's Day and we are here to celebrate dads. You know, boys and girls, if you look around you, everybody has the same father. Now, I didn't say they have the same dad, but they have the same father. And we're gonna learn a little bit more about that today. Boys and girls, I'm so excited that you're here with us today. Let's open up with a word of prayer. Dear God, thank you so much for allowing us to look into your word. We love you and we praise you and we ask you to bless us during this time in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, boys and girls, the Godfather is the name of our lesson today, and we're going to talk a little bit more about that. In the meantime, we're going to skip over our power verse and we're going to go right to our video with Ashton.
Hey there, my name is Ashton and I've been working on this puzzle for hours. It's almost done. You're just in time to see the final. Wait a second, this puzzle is totally missing a piece. Oh man, I worked so hard on this puzzle and it's totally missing a piece. You know, this puzzle reminds me of some families I know. Some families are missing a very important piece. You know what that is? Dads. Some kids don't have a dad, or they don't live with their dad, and they don't get to see him very often. It's hard living without a dad, especially on holidays like Father's Day. But you want to know something cool? We all have the same father. Now, I didn't say we all have the same dad. I said we all have the same father. You know who I'm talking about? I'm talking about God. The Bible calls God our Heavenly Father, and He's a pretty awesome Father, too. God has promised to be there for us no matter what. When times get tough, He's there. Even if we mess up and sin, He's still there for us. God is never going to leave us, no matter what. Today, you're going to learn about our perfect Heavenly Father. He's always there for us, and He has a perfect plan for our lives. I'm Ashton, and I'll see you later. Bye!
So, boys and girls, we're going to learn about just what Ashton talked about. You know, isn't it cool that we all have the same father and that God is our father? That's pretty neat. Well, today we're going to go into God's word. We're going to look at Luke chapter 15, and it's going to show us here in Luke chapter 15. This is a story that Jesus told the people because he wanted to show them, he wanted them to understand just how much God loved them. And God loves you. And so we go into the book of Luke. And it starts out by saying, a father had two sons. He had an older son and he had a younger son. Now, one day, the younger son came to his dad and he said, I want my inheritance. Give me my share of the inheritance. So, an inheritance, boys and girls, is things, monies, possessions that a father may have that when he dies, he splits it up among his children. Well, this young boy said, I want it now. The son wanted to live by himself. He decided that he would be better off on his own. No rules, no boundaries, no bedtime, no chores. He thought he would have an amazing life of fun and no worries. Well, boys and girls, the father gave his son what he asked for. And the son left and went to live on his own. Well, he had lots of friends. He was drinking and partying and living a sinful life. And he thought he had a lot of friends. But you know what, boys and girls? They only wanted him or liked him for his money. And soon, God's word tells us that His money ran out. He had wasted all his money on stuff that wouldn't last. And he ended up with no money for anything. So, he had no money for food either. So he was starving, and he knew, oh, what am I going to do? I'm so hungry. So he went to a farmer, and he asked him if he could have a job. Boys and girls, this is the job that he got. He got to feed the pigs. Can you imagine mud, slop, smelly pigs? Oh, it was the worst job. Yet even the slop he was feeding to the pigs looked good. God's word tells us that he became so hungry that even the pods he was feeding the pigs looked good to him, but no one gave him anything. When he finally came to his senses, he realized that even the pigs were eating better than he was. And he realized that even his father's servants were living better than the pigs and better than him. And so God's word says that when he finally came to his senses, he said to himself, at home, even the hired servants have enough food to spare. And here I am dying of hunger. I will go home to my father and say, Father, I have sinned against both heaven and you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Please take me on as a hired servant. So, he realized that he needed to go home. Now, boys and girls, he was probably thinking on his way home, ooh, I bet he's going to be really mad at me. I bet my father is going to yell at me, or he's going to be angry and he's going to give me a long talk about, I told you you wouldn't. Well, maybe the dad wouldn't even talk at all. He would be so angry with him. But the son knew that he needed to go back. So, as he came to his father's house, his loving father, who had been watching for him every day, hoping that his son would return, his father saw him, and it says, filled with love and compassion, he ran to his son, and boys and girls, he embraced him, he hugged him, and he kissed him, and he showed him that he loved him. And boys and girls, the son said to his father, Father, I have sinned against both heaven and you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Boys and girls, the father said, this is my son who was lost and now has been found. You know, Jesus told the people that this is like God, our Father. That the Father here in this story is like God, our Heavenly Father, who is compassionate and loving and forgiving. And the Son, boys and girls, the Son is all God's children who try to live life on their own without God. They want to make the rules. They want to make the bedtimes. They don't want to go by what God advises them to do. But you know what, boys and girls? Just like this dad loves his son, God, our Heavenly Father, loves you. He loves you, he'll wait for you patiently, and he never gives up. You know, boys and girls, God is the perfect father. He's a perfect father. Now, you may think, hey, Miss Donna, my dad is perfect. And I'm sure that he's a good dad, but he's not perfect. He makes wrong choices sometimes, and sometimes he doesn't do as good as he should. But God, our Heavenly Father, is perfect. He will never leave you nor abandon you. That's what our power verse says today. You know the dolls, Barbie and Ken? Ken is the perfect dad. He has the perfect haircut. He's got the perfect teeth. He's got the perfect car. Their lives are perfect, but there's a problem. They're not real. No one's family life is perfect because all of us have sin. And because we make wrong choices, we hurt other people. And so that means we're not perfect. But boys and girls, God is perfect. He is the perfect Father. He is the only one that's perfect. And you know what, boys and girls? God not only is perfect, but He has a perfect love. Now, you may have people in your lives who say, oh, I'm your friend. I love you. I'll never leave you. And then maybe you disagree with them on something, and they decide they're not your friend anymore, and they're not going to hang around with you. Boys and girls, with God our Father, you don't have to worry about that, because God, it has a perfect love. His love never changes. There's nothing you can do that would make God stop loving you. And there's nothing you can say that would make God stop loving you. Boys and girls, He loves you no matter what. And if you make a wrong choice or you do something that you know wouldn't please Him, all you have to do is just ask Him to forgive you, and He will. And He loves you. Just like the dad in our story, the son came back and he said, Father, I have sinned against you in heaven. And the dad just loved on him. That's what God our Father wants you to do. If you've messed up, just come to Him and say, I'm sorry. God, I have sinned. I've done the wrong thing. Please forgive me. And God will, because He has a perfect love. God is a perfect Father. God has a perfect love. And boys and girls, you were created by God, and He has a perfect plan for your life. There is nothing in your life that He doesn't already know about. He has a perfect plan for your life. And that perfect plan is that He will never fail you and He will never abandon you. He loves you. Now, there are people, because we have sin, that may let you down. They may disappoint you. Your Heavenly Father never will. God's Word tells us that He loves us with an everlasting love. He has a perfect plan. Boys and girls, you have a choice, though. You can choose His plan, or you can be like the younger son who said, I want to do my own thing. I don't want to follow God. I want to do my own thing. No chores, no rules. Boys and girls, God will never let you go. He loves you, and He will continue to look for you. As the Father said, this is my son who was lost, and now he's found. Boys and girls, our verse, our power verse for today is found in Joshua 1:5, and it says, for I will not leave you, I will not fail you or abandon you. Joshua 1:5. This is God telling His people that He will not leave them. You will never be alone. I will not fail you. He won't let you down or abandon you. Joshua 1:5. Let's say it all together, boys and girls. Joshua 1:5. For I will not leave you, I will not fail you or abandon you. Joshua 1:5. Boys and girls, I hope that you've enjoyed the lesson today on the lost son. I hope that you have a great Father's Day. And if there's some reason that you can't be with your earthly dad, then just thank your heavenly Father, for he loves you and he will never leave you nor abandon you. We're going to pray, and then I've got an announcement. Dear Heavenly Father, God, thank you so much for these boys and girls. Lord, I just pray that you would just encourage their hearts with your love, your compassion. Lord, help them to know that you are God the Father. We love you for your word. We pray for those, Lord, that maybe not be feeling well or are hurting, Lord. We just pray that you would touch them in a special way. We love you, we praise you, and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Boys and girls, next week, the 28th, I think that possibly some of you may be coming back to church, but we're not going to do children's ministry right yet. But what we are going to do is we're going to keep on doing the video series, and next week our series is on bugs. Yep, bugs. So I'll be talking to you next week. Have a great week, boys and girls. Take care. Bye-bye.